Hello and welcome! In the last video about transformers, we found out how the transformer architecture works. In this video, you will find out how the transformer architecture can process images and text simultaneously. But let's not spoil everything already and start with the beginning. The transformer architecture has proven to be very impactful in natural language processing. But what can be even cooler than looking at only text? Well, looking at text and images at the same time. And because we speak about two different input types being processed by a machine learning algorithm, we are here speaking about multimodal learning. Okay, but what does this have to do with transformers? Well, they can be applied to multimodal problems too, like for integrating vision and language in a unified model. How cool is that? This kind of model has been proposed almost simultaneously by a number of different researchers. All these papers proposed almost concurrently the same base model, of course with some slight variations, but with the same basic idea. They process language and images simultaneously with a transformer architecture, and most often the transformer architecture chosen is BERT, a bidirectional version of the transformer. And to it, they add the capability of processing visual input in the same time with language input. We will not discuss all of these papers here. You can find a comprehensive list of most of them linked below in the description. Discussing all these papers would not only take a while, but because of the high topic overlap, it would be also quite redundant. Instead, Miss Coffee Bean chose her favorite paper by the Facebook AI team. She chose this one over all others because they provided the code base, which is not only available for everyone, but also clean and maintained. In the following, we will discuss first how image and language are integrated at once in the BERT transformer model, and second about the training procedure, which I would like to call
the pre-trainception.
Okay, so let's dive into it. From now on, we will call this the transformer module, which is formed like we have explained in the last video. So it is formed of the multi-head self-attention layer, the feed-forward layers, and the residual connections acting like information highways between them. So this everything now is the transformer module. The trick here is to train the model on text-image pairs, like images and their captions. The text part is easy to explain because it is exactly like what the usual BERT architecture does. We feed the word or tokens in vector representation together after we added the positional embeddings or identifiers to these vectors. So our model is informed about the word order by these positional embeddings. And we feed this to our usual transformer module to process the text. Now, let's put the text part to the side a little bit and see what we can do on the image side. We also have to somehow transform our image into a vector sequence format because the transformer is specialized for exactly this, sequences. But how? Well, the idea is, if we combine vision and language anyway, why not have an architecture that specializes on finding correspondences between words and image regions? Ach, regions, there we said it. Let's extract such image regions and order them in an arbitrary sequence. We can represent each region by a vector, by employing a CNN-based neural network that we borrow from computer vision. Good, we got this far. Now the idea is to really compute these correspondences between image regions and the text by adding the layers that do this computation with co-attention. Now, what does co-attention mean? Until now we had attention, we had self-attention, now we have co-attention. Well, while the usual transformer modules in green look only at their own branch for computing attention through self-attention, the co-attention modules in blue are looking also at the other branch to compute importance scores between images and text and vice versa. So with co-attention, the image computes attention based on the text and vice versa. For refinement, we add then another layer of transformers and another co-attention layer and another transformer module and another, and you get it. The deeper, the better. We are doing deep learning here, huh? Now, the question is, how do we end this? How do we get to our output? And what is our output, anyway? Well, it depends what we train our network to do. It can be just a multi-layer perceptron followed by a softmax for getting out a score, for example, for the similarity between image and text. This is really dependent on the task, and the whole network can have many of these output heads, one for each task it is trained on, and sometimes it is trained also in parallel on many different tasks. So naturally, we have to discuss what we train this monster to do. And this pre-trainception, how I like to call it, it is a very interesting part. Because like in every inception, we have multiple stages. And here we are ready to explain what stage one is. We do pre-training at this first stage on the text side and on the image side, but separately. For the text, we have BERT trained on huge amounts of English text. So we take that BERT weights and use them here to initialize our BERT modules. Then the image side has to be also pre-trained to produce useful features from the images. Here in the ViLBERT paper, they have used a faster RCNN architecture, useful in object detection for computer vision. For the second stage of pre-training, the ViLBERT paper uses the conceptual captions dataset. They use this one and no other because it is huge and contains images and their captions. And on this conceptual captions dataset, they train the network that was already trained on English text further with the following objectives. One task is to predict labels for what the image regions might be. Another training task is also followed at this stage, which is masked word prediction, like in the classical transformer. So here, the model would ideally predict mountain, because it knows from the image through co-attention layers what should fall into that place best. And we are already at the training stage number 3, where the same model that at stage 1 learned to process images and text separately, at stage 2 combines them and understands the relations between text and image, and is now ready to be trained to solve a task involving both textual and visual modalities. Such tasks are, for example, visual question and answering, where the model is given an image and a question, and it has to provide the right answer to the question based on the image. ViLBERT not only beat the state of the art at the time of publication on this task, but by a large margin. Visual common sense reasoning is the better brother of visual question and answering, where the system has to provide the answer to the question, but also to give the reason for the answer. And ideally, this reason is, you know, reasoning about the problem and is not giving a tautologic explanation like this picture is a mountain because it is a mountain, but rather an explanation that this image depicts a mountain because the mountain is taller than the horizon, for example. Here, ViLBERT also achieved state of the art by a large margin. Image retrieval is the task where, given a caption of an image, the model has to select the right image that is described by the caption from a pool of many other images. And surprise, surprise, state of the art again for ViLBERT. Phrase grounding is a more fine-grained task, but also perfect for ViLBERT that, thanks to the co-attention layers, learns relationships between image regions and words, because here in this task, given a phrase in the caption like mountain, the system has to identify the region that this phrase refers to. And yes, again, state of the art for ViLBERT.
Yay!
So now that you have seen pre-training in so many stages, first on text, on images, then on text and images, and you have seen how this has helped ViLBERT to perform so well on many downstream tasks, we can safely say that this whole pre-trainception, or, you know, different stages or strategies to pre-train the model before being applied and trained further on a downstream task, is really, really helpful. And because these pre-training strategies are so cool, we will spend the whole next video only about this.
Yay!
We will discuss different pre-training strategies, because ViLBERT follows only two of the pre-training strategies, but there are others proposed in other papers about multimodal transformers. So we will see these strategies in the next video, and not only strategies for multimodal transformers, but also for the pure language BERT. See you then!